ain't want kids. You don't want nobody with kids. So I ain't want to mess up nothing.
She want kids.
You know what I'm saying? Baby 11. We got together 13 years ago. So what you just went and had a baby with somebody else?
Oh, it ain't nothing like that.
Oh, no, it's just like that. The boy is 11.
Listen, we took a break, right?
Yeah.
All right, then. So things happened, and now he's here.
The break was only for a week. So you mean to tell me in that week that we took that break that you went and got somebody?
She didn't want to tell you, but listen, we didn't focus.
So why didn't you tell me? I'm not taking no child.
I told you
why
I didn't tell you.
Because I didn't want a child. The boy is 11. That's not an excuse.
Okay,
I don't take that.
Now we're here.
I don't. Okay, and we're here, and now you're about to be gone.
Oh, really? What's...
Hold up. She said, now you're here, you about to be gone. Can I talk about how obsessed I was with that song when it first came out? Like, to this day, I still love that song to death. Like, just love it, okay? Can we thank TikTok and Instagram for putting us on to, like, some lit-ass songs that we probably would have never known if it wasn't for the app? Like, what up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today, we're gonna be doing another reaction. This one is gonna bother a lot of you guys, so I don't know if it's a trigger warning, if it's a piss off warning, but I'm just gonna say right off the bat, a lot of y'all gonna be real, real upset watching this video. A lot of you guys are probably not gonna be able to sit through it. Essentially, we're gonna be reacting to a woman who's been with a man, and the man brings home a child that essentially he had while they were together, and he brings the child home expecting his wife to accept this child. Now, one of my friends sent this video to me on TikTok. I cannot tell if it's real or not. I don't think it's fake. Whether it's real or fake, there is child. I have too much to say about it. I don't understand why this situation is happening the way it's happening, but you guys are gonna understand what I'm talking about when we react to this video. Of course, before we get into the video, make sure you guys smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, smash every video you know that can help a sister out. Please make sure you guys join the Patreon for early access, exclusive bonus videos that you won't be finding anywhere else, and you get to join the exclusive Discord. If you guys can't afford it, don't worry. Feel free to join my free Discord. It's always linked down below. There's only 100 spots left. I'm trying to cap it at 500. We're about 400 right now, so at 500 we ain't letting nobody else in on the free Discord. And of course, make sure you guys peep the description box for everything that you guys continuously ask me about down below. Follow me on Instagram. I post dancing videos on there, lifestyle content, everything that you guys want to know about my locks or whatever, all the things that you care about regarding me is on the IG. And I just made a TikTok, so feel free to follow that too. All the handles are the same, forever on the screen. Let's get straight into the reaction. This video is kind of long, y'all, so get your tea, get your snacks, get everything you need, because we might be here for a while. All right, guys. Where's my lemonade? I got my little lemonade. I should put some liquor in that sheet. If you're under 21, don't do it nothing, my friends. Okay.
I already explained what's going on. He's staying with them. It is what it is. I'm not taking no child that's not mine that I didn't know about. He's not taking no child with Mary. I don't know this little boy. We married. When did this happen? You want to get to know him? I want to get to know a child. He 11. That little boy ain't gonna listen to me no way. Child, I saw this part of the video and I was just like,
You dead ass. Okay, now I will listen. First things first. Usually when I watch any of these videos with you guys, it's my first time watching them. So I'm gonna be 1000% honest with you guys and tell you guys that I already watched this video. So this is going to be 100% commentary. So I will say, when I got to this part of the video, my moral compass was going, wait, okay, but you're married. Wait, it's supposed to be for better or worse. Can we take out for better or worse out the vows? I understand marriage is supposed to be for forever, and I used to be one of those people that was like, you know what, I don't believe in marriage, okay, now I believe in marriage, okay, now if I'm gonna be married, that means it's forever, I don't give a fuck, I'm never getting divorced, but now I'm like, ooh, there's a lot of exceptions to that rule now, because you try to lay hands on me, bitch, divorce, better yet, you going to the jail, you going under the jail, you better hope I don't beat your ass, okay, and then, you know, we go into other murky waters that I'm not going to talk about on camera. So now it's just like, when I see something like this, it's just like, okay, I see both sides, right? So definitely comment down below. I really want to see your thoughts and opinions on this. Do you believe marriage is truly for better or worse? Do you think that that should be removed from the vows? Because I'm sorry, I'm not dealing with this shit either. But we also have to address the fact that they're having this conversation in front of an innocent child that doesn't need to hear any of this. This child is an innocent party in the matter and is sitting here hearing their, well, stepmother and father talk about them in a very horrible manner. They're hearing their to-be stepmother. I don't know if I want to call that woman his stepmother, because like, she doesn't want him to be her stepchild. She doesn't want to take care of him. She doesn't want anything to do with him. She didn't even know he existed. So I mean, I'm just gonna use stepson and stepmother, you know, stepchild, whatever, loosely here, because the terminology is going to make the video go faster. However, we have to be real here. That is just the most disgusting thing to do, to have this type of conversation, to have this type of heavy, life-altering, emotionally damaging conversation in front of this child. It's just unacceptable. Like, I would have told this child to leave the room. I would have stayed the conversation for later. I would have moved this conversation to another part of the house. Like, you don't do something like this. Like, I literally was just like, wait. I understand where he's coming from. I understand where she's coming from. But oh my God, the child is standing right there. Like that, bruh. And I was like, I literally paused this. I had to rewind it like 3 times. Pause it again. Like, what the fuck? Like, mind blown. Because what the hell? And we also need to take into consideration that when men do this, they expect women to fall in line. Okay? Oh, well, for better or worse, you're going to have to do what it do. It is what it is. But let a woman do this, he out the door before the announcement's even made. Okay? Like, ain't no accepting a child. Better yet, ain't no accepting the pregnancy. Better yet, ain't no accepting the cheating. Okay? Let a woman cheat on a man. Oh, she's a whore. She's a harlot. She's this, that, and the third. She ain't shit. She broke her vows. Leave her. She ain't no good. But a man cheats and everybody be like, oh, well, man be a man. Dogs be dogs. Boys be boys. A man always comes home. It ain't nothing as long as he come home to you. Like, the hypocrisy of this is insane to me, because he has the nerve, gall, audacity to have cheated on her, to literally have been comfortable enough with another woman to have a baby with her, and then to bring that baby to her doorstep to say, you need to accept this child. It's ridiculous. It's ass a fucking nine. It truly is.
Okay, listen, we've been together 13 years. Something has went down and I have to get my son. It is what it is. He got to stay here now. You have to accept.
No, this too soon. I don't think that. No, this ain't right. This ain't
right.
What's
not right about it?
Everything ain't right. We've been together 13 years. Who was your mama, baby? Who was the mama?
It doesn't matter.
It does matter. This happened when we were together. We had our issues throughout these years. Yeah, I don't even know who the mama is.
I never told you for a reason, though.
It does matter. Okay, see, this is the thing. This is why I've said it so many times, and a lot of my friends get upset at me at this. And this is why when they had their little bullationships, yes, I said bullationships, write it down. Okay, so the next time when your friends be like, oh, we're on a break, tell them you're not in a relationship, you're in a bullationship, because there's no such thing as a break in a relationship. Repeat after me. There's no such thing as a break in a relationship. If you're in a relationship, you're in a relationship, or you're not. In these whole situations, having breaks doesn't fucking exist. And you guys probably like, oh, you and your man never been on a break? Me and my man been together for 3 years. We will be 4 years in October. We have never taken a break. Any man that I get with, I'm like, hey, yo, I don't do the break shit. Either we together or we not. Because if you gonna be sitting here, think we on breaks, and you gonna be fucking here and I'm gonna be fucking there, we not together. Don't be thinking you about to be coming to my house and then coming to her house and then coming in his house. And we ain't doing that shit. We not. don't got time for that goofy shit. What you allow is what is going to continue. When you sit here having these willy-nilly conversations, having these willy-nilly relations with people, they treat you willy-nilly. It doesn't make sense. Like, I could never understand why people allow people that they're with to have these breaks. I understand shit happens and you might have breakups, but call it what it is, a breakup. It is not a break. Okay, and even if you are going to break up, define what the fuck a breakup is. Can you have relations with other people? Are you going to come back together at a certain time? Does this mean that you can have other relationships? Like, please define that, because shit like this will happen. Where now, you got a fucking oopsie baby showing up to your door 10 years later. Can you fucking imagine? Can you fucking imagine? Like, it doesn't even make sense. And that's because a lot of you guys want to do whatever the fuck you want, but still want to be in relationships. Where they do that at? Cote your face out. It doesn't make sense. Either you together or you not. Like, every single time one of my friends tell me that shit, I'm like, I don't want to hear it no more. I don't want to hear it no more because it's ridiculous. Like, I kid you not, I'd rather be in a situationship than a bullationship that has a bunch of breaks. I don't have time for that because I can't be in a relationship where I don't know where I stand, where I'm constantly with this person today, then I'm not with them next month, then I'm not with them next year, but I was with them last month, then I missed my period this time, but I don't know if the father is my boyfriend, or the nigga I met in the club, or like, listen, it's just too much for me, like, it's too much for me, then I gotta look on his Instagram, see who he on a date with, like, who got time for that, like, no, like, and then the fact that he talked about some, oh, you don't even know who the mother is, yes, the fuck I do. Now, I will say my reaction to this type of situation would be completely different based on if the mother was deceased, incarcerated, or literally having a very serious hardship, or like literally just co-parenting. Like, there's a lot of different scenarios here. Now, I always say I do not date men with kids. I will never probably date a man with kids unless I had kids myself and I was divorced or widowed. That's probably the only way I would do it, because the whole man with kids thing, this is why. But she probably intentionally was the same way, and now you're bringing a fucking child to her doorstep. So I can't even blame her for this, because you can't be fucking with people's lives like this. You cheated on her, now you want her to accept the fact that you cheated and that you had a baby on her. And it's not even a baby, this is a whole fucking kid. This is practically a teenager, bro. So I'm trying to understand what you expect her to do and why you don't want to give her the answers that she's looking for. If the mother is incarcerated or dead, that's the only way I'm taking a child in. Like, that's the only way. And that man gotta be the most phenomenal, like, man ever. And trust me, been there, done that. I already done the story times before, and it still was a little, okay? So it's just like, how you gonna talk about something the mother don't matter? Like, I would really be sad if, like, that boy's mother, like, literally passed away and you're sitting here treating him like that, because it's like, it's a bad take, sis. Like, that's kind of fucked up. Like, you're treating this kid like shit, and their mother probably passed away. That'd be really horrible. But, you know, we have to be unbiased here. That has absolutely nothing to do with the woman. That has nothing to do with your wife. That has nothing to do with her. And that might sound harsh, but it doesn't. Black women especially have spent too much time caring about other people, not enough time caring about themselves, and that has landed us in our position now. And we need to also be 1000% real here. If the roles were reversed, he wouldn't give a fuck about us. Sage, I don't want your hair to go on my lemonade, okay? If the roles were reversed, he would have left her in a heartbeat. So it's just like, I don't know.
Reason you don't keep a child from nobody.
We ain't want kids, you don't want nobody. We kids, so I ain't want to mess up nothing.
She want kids.
You know what I'm saying? We on the baby 11, we got together 13 years ago. So what you just went and had a baby with somebody else?
Oh, it ain't nothing like that.
Oh, it's just like that. The boy is 11.
Listen, we took a break, right?
Yeah.
All right, then, so things happened, and now he's here.
The break was only for a week, so you mean to tell me in that week that we took that break? That you ain't got somebody.
I know my table. Listen, we
didn't
focus.
So why didn't you tell me? I'm not taking any child.
I didn't tell you.
Because I didn't want a child. The boy is 11. That's not that's not an excuse. Okay, I don't take
now
that.
We here.
I don't. Okay, and we here, and now you about to be gone.
Oh, really? What's
hold up. She said, now you here, you about to be gone. Ew. That's crazy, bruh. This. Look at his face, y'all. Look at this man. He is flabbergasted. He is stunned. He is too stunned to speak. That is literally the epitome of he was too stunned to speak. Look at his face. Caca boye.
Oh, very really. Yeah, we can cut. I mean, I don't know.
So you really go through a whole divorce, then take me my son?
This too much for me. This too soon. Much. It's too much. He's too old. This too much.
Yeah, 11 years old.
It's too much. And we 13 years in, and I'm just supposed to bring in some 11-year-old.
Yeah, we can work at it. You can be a stepmom, can't you? Like I'm saying, like you married. That's what come in.
I don't know if I can work at this.
What you mean?
Nah, and what you mean is what I'm gonna do, and
to
I mean what I'm
gonna do. All that to health and sickness, all that shit matter right now. What I'm trying to tell you.
Y'all don't take marriage seriously, bro. How you gonna cheat on somebody, have a baby on them, not tell them about it, and then 11 years later throw the vows in their face, and then talk about some till death do us part? What? All of that matters now. Did it matter when you were balls deep in another woman cheating on me while we were on a break? See, but who knows? Who knows what the break entailed? Maybe you guys were allowed to be balls deep in other people when you were on a break. This is why I don't do breaks. It's too much confusion for me. I already got ADHD. I don't need to know different rules for a different relationship that I'm not even in. Relationships. Because they're full of bullshit, ladies and gentlemen.
Vows matter right now. This is the time they matter. You understand that, right?
No. This has nothing to do with your vows, bro.
So, child, I already have children of my own with you. And you want me to bring in a child that's not mine, that's
years.
Yours, that you kept from me?
So you want to throw in 13 years?
Yeah, we're going to have to throw this away. This too much. It's not for me. You him and your son, do what you gotta do.
Yeah,
be a man.
All that. I'm going to hell when I got
all that, but just do that. Do it without me. Do that without me.
I will say, when I watched this the first time, I didn't really peep that she kind of said, like, throw that all away or whatever the fuck she said. What y'all hear that last part. I didn't really peep that. Nonetheless, I don't know. Like, the whole thing leaves a bad taste in my mouth because the kid is right there hearing all of this. I don't like it, Mim, because he doesn't deserve that. He's just a child. He shouldn't be there listening to his parents bicker and complain about where he's going to go, you feel me? About, you know, like, what's gonna happen to, not even his parents, his stepmom and his father worry about where he's gonna live and the fact that she doesn't wanna take him in. And it's sad because technically his father put him in that position. If you wanna be real here, your father's the one that kinda fucked your life up at this point. Oof. Now, comment down below. I wanna hear your thoughts and opinions. Would you get a divorce over this? I would say, I love kids a lot. This is the thing. I love kids so much that I kind of put the needs of kids before mine. And I'm so afraid to fuck a kid's life up to the point where, like, I kind of forget a kid and I see a kid like 10, 15 years from now and they see me in Dunkin' Donuts and they're like, oh, Miss Ivana, or oh my God, you're Ivana. Like, yeah, I remember you said this to me, or yeah, you fucked my life up. Fuck you. Like, I know that's so extra. I just made a whole scenario up in my head, ADHD's bitch. But I'm saying, like, I don't want a kid to see me later on in the future and remember me fucking them up or remember having a horrible experience with me. Be it me as their dance teacher or me in a personal capacity. And in general, I just really do like kids. So I can't even say I would, even though part of me, just because I'm doing this video and I feel so strongly about this man being trash, I'd be like, hell yeah, divorce. That has nothing to do with me. I don't know, because this kid looks thoroughly sad. And he does not deserve that. And if anything, he deserves another shot at having a mom. So it's just like, I'd probably dump him and take the kid. Because is that possible? Can someone who's familiar with family law give me the synopsis of that? Because I'm pretty sure that since you're his wife, you could probably do that. But I wouldn't want to be with him anymore. But I don't think the kid should suffer for that. So I'd probably do something like that.
So you're not trying to discuss it no more? You ain't trying to figure out
anything? He ain't got all the family? What about the family?
Oh, his family.
Okay, so you got your grandma? Right? Yeah, and we got our family. He not
my
family. I don't know this boy. I don't know
my family. It's your family. Like, we're together.
So let me ask you something. So you just been How long have you known that you had this son?
Listen, that's another question.
You know since the beginning? Listen, you know since the beginning?
Camera off, all like,
I'm not turning on camera off nothing. I'm not turning on because.
Who is this?
My business. My business. I'm going to be looking at this.
So you saying, so all you saying is
I need this for the courts.
You rather us not, you know what I'm saying, continue this marriage or because I have a son?
He's 11.
So what?
You can, if you can keep a lie for 11 years, then are you lying about anything?
That's true. Lie.
That is a lie. Not telling me is a lie.
You didn't ask me.
I don't have to ask you. We married, remember?
I will say, like, how long did he really have this son? Like, I really want to know, too. Like, how long did he know? Like, was he secretly going to see this son for 11 years? That's actually pretty scary. Like, if he knew he had a son this whole time and really didn't say anything, like, what else have you been hiding? On top of that, why do you think it's okay to have a kid for this long and not say anything to anyone? On top of that, why do you think it's a responsibility to take care of your child when you brought this child to your your wife's doorstep or your doorstep? You know what I mean? To your family home just out of nowhere. Like, that's traumatic. Like, she's gonna have to process a lot of different things. The lying, the infidelity, the child. It's like, you just expect her to do that willy-nilly? Like, I'm not a fan. Like, no. And I really need to ask you guys another question. I need you guys to answer in the comment section down below. Like, does it make a difference if he knew? Or would you guys accept the child if he literally just found out today? Like, I've always said another way I would only accept a child being brought to my doorstep by a man that I was with is if he genuinely didn't know. Like, literally, we sitting down watching Netflix, doorbell rings, and a child pops up like, hey, you're my dad. And it's like, oh shit, well, we ain't know. All right, hey, son. Like, that's the only way. Because at that point, like, what are we supposed to do? Maybe it was a one-night stand before me. Or, like, you know, like, something like that. You know, but, like, in this case, I don't know. Like, maybe he really did just find out about this kid. I don't believe it, though, because he looked a little guilty when she asked that question. But comment down below. Do you guys think he knew? I think he knew. And if he did or didn't, would that make a difference in your choice of divorce or not? I don't know. I don't know, because kids are a very soft spot for me, especially kids that are coherent. Like, if he was a baby, it'd be easier for me to be like, fuck no, he ain't got no conscience. He don't know shit yet. But he's an adult, pretty much. Not an adult, but he's a kid with feelings. He's a kid with emotion. He's a kid that understands what's going on, so.
Listen, things happen, and I didn't feel like you were ready for all that. So
things happen.
It is what it is.
Who are you to tell me what I'm ready for?
Look how you acting now.
Exactly, so if you would have told me sooner, what? I might have not reacted in this way. What you mean how that makes sense? I would have known sooner while he was a child, and I would have been like, oh, okay, this happened. I might be mad for a minute. So, it happened when we weren't together.
You doing all this. You 13 years and you doing all this until I brought my son home.
You brought an 11-year-old son home.
So he was a baby, it'd be different.
It might have been different.
It might have, yeah.
So it might have been. You don't know because you didn't ask. You kept it a secret.
But he, my son, he has to be here. Do you understand?
Okay, but and then like I said, you know, handle that. I don't want no parts of it. I'm sorry, baby. You seem like you probably a little sweet, baby, but I don't want no parts of this. Okay, I'm sorry what happened to your mama. But then you foul. This is foul.
Something really must have happened. I will say the filming is a bit much, but I will say for court purposes it's fine. Posting it on TikTok, child. I will say thank you TikTok, Instagram, social media for paying my bills. I definitely appreciate it. However, I wouldn't have posted this. This is just fucked up. That kid doesn't deserve that. He doesn't need to be exploited like this. It's bad enough that, what in the world? It's bad enough he's being rejected like this. You don't need his face showing like this. It's just unnecessary.
Yeah, bye. You wild. You heard what I said.
I said, who you recording for though?
For the court.
For TikTok.
You getting a divorce.
It's okay.
For the court. Thank you.
Have a
good day. Why
are
you coming all outside?
Because
I can.
What?
Goodbye.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Seeing us all.
Yes, goodbye. I know what it is. It's all good. This is crazy. I ain't never had it. It's crazy. 13 years and a boy come. He come from nowhere.
First time
he came from nowhere.
And you just acting all belligerent for what?
What do you mean for what? know you.
Right.
Because keeping a lie like that, saying, ain't no telling what else you lied to me about.
I don't know nothing else. This was not
the bad business, you know.
Wow. Okay. Come on.
Yeah. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Don't listen. Don't try to fix it later.
Hey, Nate, you
right.
Gotta take care of your baby.
Right. Okay.
Well, that was a shit show. I've been trying to find the original account that came from. So if any of you guys know, please send it to me on Instagram. My at is always on the screen and link down below. I cannot believe that shit. Like, I actually didn't watch it fully the first time because I didn't get to see the full part of them going outside. But I will say that's ridiculous. It truly is. It's just the audacity. Okay, it's truly the audacity, not only the audacity, but the entitlement of a lot of men. To be quite honest with you, I like to treat people the way I want to be treated. I don't give a fuck about the niceties. I don't give a fuck about the stereotypes. I don't give a fuck about all that extra shit. Like, if you wouldn't want me to do it to you, don't do it to me. Like, I'm very strict about that. Like, I can't stand the fact that a lot of men just do things specifically because they're men and they know that they could get away with it. Like, the fact that he sat here and brought that kid over there knowing damn well if she would have did the same thing, it would have been an issue, is crazy. Like, clearly a woman can't hide a pregnancy. But imagine they would have been together for 13 years. However, maybe she had a 15-year-old and he just, you know, and she just brought that 15-year-old over there. Like, hey, yeah, I have a 15-year-old, you know, from a previous marriage. Like, it wouldn't be the same thing entirely. But you understand, like, hiding a whole baby is a child, okay? Technically, a grown child is fucked up. Okay, because like, how could you be in conversation? How can you be in a relationship? How can you have any type of connection with someone and never bring up that you have a child? Especially for over a decade. Like, that's a different type of person. I've always said I never trust anyone that I'm having any type of connection with that never brings up their child if they have one. Like, that's just shady to me. It's like, do you not care about your kids? Do you not love your kids? Are you okay? Like, why would you not bring up that you have kids? Like, I feel like that's just shiesty. Like, I don't know what type of person you are that you don't bring up that you have kids. Like, are you ashamed? Like, it's just weird. Like, the fact that he, 11 years, never bring up that you have a kid. And then you have that poor child just sitting there, listening to your fucking shenanigans. That child does not deserve to sit there and listen to y'all pure shenanigans. Why? Y'all could have had that conversation a whole other time, but instead, you chose to have that conversation in front of him. You have that child. That child is probably going to remember that for the rest of his life. Okay, that child sitting there hearing how he is unwanted. Hearing that his stepmother didn't even know about him until the moment he walked into the house and she wasn't even happy to meet him. Can you imagine meeting your step-parent for the first time and they don't even care to meet you? Like, they don't even like you and they don't even want to like you at this point? Like, and I completely understand she's upset. I completely understand technically her grievances are not with that child. However, it comes off that way. A lot of the things that she said, I had to like pause and rewind the first time I was watching because I'm like, I know she didn't mean it towards him, but if I was the child, it would have came off as if it was coming towards me. Because there were certain points where she was like, nah, go handle that. Go handle your kid. Oh, bitch, go see your kid. That's not okay. And again, I understand emotions run high, but you don't do that. That's a child at the end of the day. And children internalize a lot of different things. And they manifest a lot of different feelings into different actions later on. So it's just like, I really hope later on she kind of understood that what she did was wrong. Maybe she reached out to that kid. I don't know. But that part was just not it. That just killed like 50% of the video for me. Because it was just like, that kid was sitting right there and did not need to be there. Okay, so what the... That shit hurt. It was just seeing that kid's face for me that I just was like, do we have to do that? So with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please make sure to leave your comments down below. I love you guys so very much. Please subscribe to the Patreon for early access. bonus videos, discounts on my in-person events. I will be having a live workshop August 12th where I'll be teaching you guys how to create engaging video content. It will be in Garwood, New Jersey at the Westwood. You get brunch, you get a meet and greet with me, swag bags, workbooks, the works, okay? It is definitely worth it. It's going to be linked down below. For those of you guys who cannot attend because you're not in New Jersey, stay tuned to the community tab and follow me on Instagram as well as my business, Media Hustle, on Instagram. You will have details for the online workshop that will be taking place. And I also have something lined up where you guys can continuously get mini lessons from me on a subscription base. Listen, Media Hustle, we going up this year and beyond, okay? Those guys who want to be creators, those of you guys who want social media advice for your business, Nula, all right, we got this shit locked in. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, check out my other two channels. Everything you need is going to be linked down below. I love you guys so very much, and I'ma see y'all when next time. Bye. Oh.